Fire is a global phenomenon. It occurs everywhere, and Earth is, in many regards, is a fire planet. So we see fires in Africa from agriculture burning. We see big fires in the Boreal region. We see big fires in the Brazilian Amazon related to deforestation and so on. And clearly, the only way to get this global picture is from satellites. So satellites are able to detect fires because the radiation emitted by the fires, basically these hot targets, is very specific. And if we have a sensor which is sensitive to that radiative signal, that will enable us to distinguish that area where there is a hot target, typically a fire, from the non-burning background conditions. The sensor is so sensitive to the heat signature that a rather small fire can be detected. And very often, you see the heat signature before you see the smoke. It is important to see not only where the fire is currently, but also the history of that and the spread, and basically we call it the burnt areas. It is important to map the burnt areas because that is another way of estimating how much emission occurred, how much vegetation burnt, and how much of that burning actually emitted gases and particulate matter into the atmosphere. And also, it is an indicator of the ecosystem change. So what happened to that area? What happened to the vegetation over that area? What was the aerial extent? And also, what is very important is to measure what was the severity of the fire. The new NPP satellite and the GOSAR satellite, when it gets launched, will provide us a much better capability for fire observations and characterizations from the NOAA missions. Fires have a diurnal cycle of activity, and the daytime, mid-afternoon, or early to mid-afternoon observations are the ones which provide the most information, because that's when we have the most fires occurring in most parts of the world.